Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to today's live broadcast with Stahls TV. I'll be your host today, Mike Koval. What we'll be talking about is decorating sportswear from head to toe. So not only am I my man in front of the camera, we also have some help here with us today. We have Jody, who will be our facilitator today, reading off our poll questions and helping me out with any questions I might have. We also have Joe here, who's my follow-behind camera guy, should we need any extreme close-ups for some of our decorations here. So what I'm going to do now, is before we get started into it, I want to get to know my audience a little bit better. So I'm going to have Jody launch our poll questions for today. So go ahead, Jody, if you could launch those, please.
So we're going to launch is, do you own a heat press? Well, Mike, we have 90% that do own a heat press, and we have 10% that do not own a heat press. Okay. All right, so we're going to launch another poll question. Are you currently decorating sportswear? Going to close the poll. Mike, we have 58% that are currently decorating sportswear and 42% that are not. And we're going to do one final poll question. What type of services do you offer? Okay, we're going to close that poll. The services offer, we have 8% who are screen printing, 25% are embroidery, 100% are vinyl cutting, and 42% are digital printing.
All right, well, that gives me a good idea of my audience here and you know what you all are currently doing. So let's get into everything here, and as you know the title is named, we're going to decorate sportswear from head to toe. And now a lot of reasons why people get into this industry is specifically for decorating sportswear, whether it be for their children's school, local little leagues, churches, clubs, organizations. You know, they get into this personalizing their jerseys and t-shirts with names, numbers, you know, for whatever sport that they're trying to play. You know, and then getting into doing names and numbers, you know, more and more business is coming in. You're doing it very well. You're becoming very successful just decorating with just the names and the numbers for jerseys. You know, but a lot of times, you know, you get that successful. You get the blinders on. You do one thing well, and you keep at it, which is nice. You know, but there's a lot of things you could be leaving on the table. You know, because no matter what sport that you're decorating for or what sport, you know, you're playing, there's more than just a t-shirt or a jersey that's involved in the whole uniform. So that's what we're going to get an idea at today, decorating the entire uniform. You know, so any uniforms can contain hats, the obvious t-shirts, the obvious jerseys, but also the shorts, the pants, even the shoes. And then in today's world, you know, we have a lot of advancements in materials for the athletes to wear, such as the performance wear, the moisture-wicking fabrics that are very difficult to decorate due to their fabric content. You know, a lot of different obstacles to overcome, you know, implying certain levels of heat and pressure from the heat press, and you know, some materials bleeding or not adhering properly. So Stahls has pioneered many, many different materials, you know, so that we're helping you become a complete decorator to overcome, you know, any obstacles with performance wear, advancements in heat printing to allow us to apply to many, many areas for the apparel, sleeves, as I said before, shoes, many areas of the hats, not just the front and the back, you know, for your team name and the name and number on the back. You know, so what we're going to look at today is how we're going to become a more complete decorator with the proper materials and the proper equipment with the heat press, optional platens, and things like that. So let's get started. Obviously, you know, we're from head to toe, so let's get started with the head. So as you've guessed it, we're probably going to decorate a hat. You know, so any little league, baseball team, softball team, they're going to be wearing a hat. So let's take a look at, you know, what we're going to use today, which is the cap press, in order to decorate this hat. I'm going to change the camera angle here. So here we have our Hotronics automatic open cap press, digital time, temperature, pressure readout. And so we have here our auto cap hat that we're going to decorate today. And what we're going to use first is we're going to use our Pro Cap twill lettering that you could order from us at Stahls on our website. We're very in many, many fonts, many finishes, many colors. So we're using our white today. So how we load this into the cap press, we have our hat here. You know, the most common way to decorate a hat, you know, it's with standard embroidery, you know, where you're embroidering the team name, you're embroidering the lettering, whatever it may be on that hat. That's the most common form of decoration for a hat. So, you know, for those of you who don't have embroidery, it's okay. We at Stahls have the proper lettering and materials for you to decorate hats, even though you don't have that embroidery equipment. So like I said, we're using our Pro Cap lettering. I'm going to have Joe come in here. And I'm going to go ahead and place our lettering on our cap. Just place that there. Let's see. Cap down, that'll make things a lot easier. Okay, we have our K and our C applied. These apply at 350 degrees for about 20 seconds on our heat press. So we go ahead and lock that down. Once the timer reaches zero, the heat press will open automatically for us, and then we'll have our twill lettering applied without having to have an embroidery machine to perform this decoration.
Mike, I have a question.
Okay. We have a question, which I'll get to in 1 second. There we have our twill lettering applied to the cap with just a heat press. Okay. Jody, we had a question?
I have a hat press and the 5 platens that came with it. How do I decide which platen to use?
How you decide which platen you use, it's a matter of process of elimination. You know, what you basically get your hat that you're going to decorate, place it on, you know, the platen that's currently on your press. And what you want to make sure is that you have enough platen that's going to accommodate the size of your design and also basically the whole front of this cap so you don't have any heat press indentations. Like, for instance, if you had a platen that was a little bit shorter than this, when you tried to press this, this part of the hat would bend, and then you might see a permanent crease within that cap. You know, so it's just best, you know, just to try out all that you have to make sure, A, the transfer will fit on the whole platen size, and then that entire area that you're pressing is going to be under that platen, so there's no chance of permanent creases in the hat. Anything else? Okay, and now let's take a look at one of the more hotter trends in headwear decoration. I was recently at the ISS Nashville and NBM Arlington, where we introduced a new cap bill platen. And what it allows us to do is to decorate the underside of this flat bill hat. And I tell you, you know, all the folks that were there, and when we had that cap bill platen on this heat press, it generated the most traffic and the most response I've seen in quite some time. So we'll just change this out. And I'm using this on my Hotronics Fusion. And here's what this attachment looks like. So it just pops on. Lock it in place. And so how this works is we would place this flat bill platen right in that area there. And now we have the ability to also decorate 3 hats at once. We'd basically have one here, here, and here, and we'd be able to decorate three hats at once. So let me grab my transfer and show you how it works. So we'll place our transfer there. Slide the platen in. We're applying our premium plus here. It goes on at 280 degrees. So we'll lock that down. Give this a little bit of time to cool. It's not a complete hot peel. Our decorated cap. The only way you're going to be able to do this is with this specific platen. So not only can you do the underside of the bill, but we could take this cap and flip it inside out. Do it the same way. You're going to want to remove this sticker, obviously, if you're going to decorate the front, and apply that transfer there so you can decorate both sides. Very unique application. Like I said, that's gaining a tremendous amount of popularity based on the response we had at our past two shows. We generated a number of sales for these particular platens, just people watching us do it. You know, they thought it was a very unique application outside of the norm. You know what that means? These types of unique applications, it's an upcharge for you as a sale. You know, more revenue generated from just decorating a simple hat. Okay.
I have a few questions regarding
Jenny
the platen.
Jenny has some questions.
Yes, the first one. Do you have to preheat the platen before pressing a bill?
You don't have to preheat the actual platen. You know, it won't hurt if you do, but it's not really necessary. Preheating is more necessary when you're, you know, applying to T-shirts and things like that. What it does, preheating gets any moisture, any wrinkles out of the garment that could ultimately affect the adhesion and then causing the transfer to fail.
Next question. Do you need to preheat the caps before applying the transfer?
Again, there's no real need to on a cap, you know, because there's no, you know, real areas for wrinkles there on like a T-shirt. So, I mean, if you did, it's not going to hurt anything at all, you know, but it's not necessary for a hat.
Question. How would you fit three on it at once? It looks like they would be overlapping.
Put one on here, and let me step off camera here for a second. I'll grab a couple of more. Now they do touch, you know, but they won't overlap. So we'd be able to decorate three caps at once. Question, Sherry?
Question.
Sure.
What other garments can you use for that other than hats?
Well, one unique application that Josh Ellsworth from, you know, showed some folks at the show, you can actually decorate sleeves rather easily with this as well. Let me just show you how. So we take our basic T-shirt here. If we wanted to decorate the sleeves, we could put one of the sleeves on there just like that. And we have our other sleeve here. Do the same thing right on the other side. So if we're decorating, you know, putting patches or whatever it may be on the sleeve, just place your transfers here, slide this in, you know, and change the settings to whatever it is that you're applying to, and there you have easily decorated sleeves. So not only can you decorate sleeves, but again, you'll see with the use of the cap press, you know, how you could also use the cap press for something more than caps as well. Anything else, Jody?
Does that platen work on the auto clam heat press?
It will fit on the auto clam heat press. One of the downfalls of it for the hats is there's not much clearance under the auto clam. So when you try to hit that, you know, set that cap on there, sometimes that bottom of the hat won't fit on there, so it won't sit flush. You know, so a fusion or air fusion is definitely the recommendation, you know, for the cap bill platen. Could you probably maybe make it work? Possibly, but not quite as easy as, you know, with a fusion or the air fusion. So now that we've covered some headwear, let's move on down the uniform here. We're going to go and decorate some basic t-shirts and jerseys. Okay. So since I have my t-shirt here that we were pretending we were decorating the sleeves, what we're going to do is we're going to decorate a t-shirt as with most little leagues, intramural leagues, church leagues, things like that, rather than a, real jersey. Oftentimes, for a price point, they'll just use a basic t-shirt, for the jersey wear. So we're going to decorate this using some goof-proof screen-printed transfers from Transfer Express. And now these goof-proof transfers are one of the very most simplest ways to decorate apparel. How it works is, you could use the online designer with Transfer Express to create, your custom graphics or submit your own artwork. And then what they do is they basically are doing a screen print on a piece of paper, and there's an adhesive baked into that, which allows you with the heat press to just simply heat press it to your t-shirt or even jersey for that matter. So let's just go and take a look at how that works. So we're just going to move over to our air fusion because we have our temperature set at 360 degrees. For our goof-proof transfers. Move this in here. Make sure we're straight. And with a t-shirt, I always like to do a pre-press on the pre. So we're gonna have Joe scoot in here with us. So do a quick pre-press of this, go in tack mode on my air fusion. But pre-press, like I said, what that does is get any moisture or wrinkles out of the shirt. We're going to apply, this is our screen printed transfer. As you can see, this is a screen printed Plastisol ink, just like a screen printer would use that if they were doing a direct screen print to the shirt. So we're going to take it here, we're going to flip it over, position it on our shirt. No need to use a cover sheet. This goes on at 360 degrees for about 6 seconds at a medium pressure. Oops, didn't take it out of tack mode. And this is a hot peel. And there we have it. Screen print shirt without the mess of screen printing. Very simple, very easy, very soft to the hand. Excellent way to decorate apparel. So in that sense, since we have our front cover on, logo on, we're going to go ahead and spin this around. And we could order that same goof-proof transfer in numbers. We could also order it in names. Quick, simple, and easy decoration. Basic t-shirts and jerseys with Transfer Express and their goof-proof transfers. So for those of you, without, a vinyl cutter or a digital printer for means to produce their own transfers, Transfer Express is an excellent way for you to start decorating apparel or, advancing your decoration options with them as well. So, now that we have our basic tees, covered, some applications here. We're going to go in to take a look at actual jersey printing. So what we're going to do is we have a football jersey here from Teamwork Athletic. We're going to go ahead and decorate, every area of this from the front number, a back number, with also a name. We're going to also do shoulder prints. How we're decorating this is we're using pre-cuts from Stahls. We're writing pre-space names and pre-space numbers to do this decoration here. So what we're going to do is we're going to go back over to this. Well, actually, I'm going to turn this down and use this press. And while this cools, we should be okay to decorate this. Thermofilm goes on at a 330-degree temperature, 6 seconds. Thermofilm is ideal for decorating football and game-worn jerseys due to its tough, rigid build. It's going to withstand that high impact that you see in football, even hockey. So you're not going to have to worry about that coming off once it's applied. One of the other nice things about thermofilm is that it has the ability to prevent some of the dye migration that comes through that some of you may have come across, where you decorate a red shirt and the white lettering turns pink. With the thermofilm, it has some dye blocking capabilities there to keep your numbers looking true to the color that they are. And you'll see some of the other products that we offer, when we get into decorating some of the performance wear shortly. So let's go ahead and do the easy ones first with our thermofilm pre-space numbers and pre-space names. Again, we'll load our jersey onto this press here. Why I like to load the jersey is so basically you could avoid any of these seams and areas that could affect the adhesion of the press. So let me get Joe to zoom in here and you can see what I mean. Okay. I was talking about threading, is this V-neck here and this seam going across here. Sometimes if you have a smaller heat press where you don't have the ability to thread, you'll have to use a pillow or a print perfect pad to raise this area up so these seams don't interfere with the pressure and then ultimately lead to a transfer coming off. So we'll just slide that seam down underneath there. We'll do a quick pre-press again on this shirt. This time I'll remember to take it out of tack mode. Front number. This is a pre-spaced thermofilm. We're using basic white. And not only can you order pre-space, but if you order letter kits, you could also do them individual letters, like you see here. You could order, kits of, numerals 0 through 9, and they would come to you like this, no cover sheet. So you would lay this down very much like this, but cover it with a cover sheet before you actually press it. Another option, outside of the pre-spaced, numbers, you could do a seam stitch if you wanted to get more of a professional look. Like if you ever purchased an authentic pro jersey, those letters are stitched to the garment with tackle twill. So what we've come up with as well is it's called our seam stitch. And what it is, it's a laser cut twill. As you can see, it gives the impression of stitching. And so if you want that more professional look, but yet you don't have an embroidery machine, we have that service for you where you could order your numbers in the seam stitch so that once you heat apply it, you get a more professional look outside of just vinyl. And you still get that same durability that you would with heat applied numbers as you do and even if you were embroidering those numbers. So we'll apply our 14. Forgive my placement. A little bit crooked. Thermofilms at 330 for about 8 seconds. Thermofilm is just as easy to use as we saw before in those screen printed transfers. Already done for you. It's a hot peel product. It goes on very easily. This would also work on t-shirts as well. Okay, so now I'm going to take the back number, do a quick spin fusion. What I'm going to do is I'm going to do the name and the number at once. going to do our back number. We could have also ordered this in a player perfect, which had the name and the number already spaced for you in one heat press. So, but all I had here today was just the pre-cut name and player perfect. So again, this is thermofilm, 330, 6 to 8 seconds. It's applied. Hot peel. All right, so we have successfully decorated front and a back, now onto the sleeves, all with just a heat press. Without any other specialized equipment. Now, you know, when we get into a little further, you know, into the presentation towards the end, we'll talk about, you know, beginning to create transfers yourself. So let's go ahead and do our numbers. So I'm going to jump back to this. Actually, I'll just stay on this one and use a sleeve and leg plat to allow us to easily put these shoulder numbers on. Do you have any questions, Jody?
No questions.
Okay. Yeah, folks, feel free. You know, any questions that you might want to ask, don't worry. Okay, so normally, on a sleeve platen, you might think that this would get away with it. But, you know, here's this seam here that's going to be tough to avoid, you know, with this particular platen. So what I'm going to use is a print perfect pad. What I'm going to do is just place this here. What it's going to do, it's going to raise our pressing area up so that those areas fall underneath this pad, so that all pressure of the heat press is going to be right here where we need it for our names and numbers. Actually, we're doing the shoulders. Not the sleeve. But the same thing applies. We're using that pad so that these seams here and here fall underneath there, so we get all of our pressure exerted where we want and not where we don't. So we have our number 14. Number, first one, we do the same thing for the second one. We'll have to use our pad. We won't have to move our pad, I should say. It's going to be right there ready for us. Get our other 14, and where did you go? There it is. And that noise you're hearing there is our air compressor that, you know, operates the air fusion heat press here. And we remove. There, we've decorated a complete football uniform with one heat press and a couple of different platens. Front, back, and shoulders. You know, a lot of folks may stay away from the shoulders because maybe they don't have an attachment such as the sleeve or the leg, or maybe they haven't thought about using the pad where, you know, maybe they tried it in the past and the seam, a lot of, maybe the numbers come off or not stick properly. You know, so that with addition of this sleeve platen or the use of a print perfect pad with your current heat press will allow you to take advantage of these placements. So let's move on to performance wear. And performance wear is very popular in today's market, and pretty much anybody playing sports or anybody, you know, fitness, jogging, running, you know, whatever it is, they're wearing performance wear. It's even becoming commonplace, you know, in a lot of the, you know, dress shirts and things like that that we sometimes wear at trade shows. You know, but one of the biggest things about performance wear is the fabric itself. It's a very difficult, very heat sensitive material to decorate. You know, when using a heat press sometimes with a performance wear, if you've ever tried it, you've had that heat press box. You know, well, that's typically because of the high heat and the high pressure of the heat press. You know, so what we've, Stahls has come up with was our CAD Cut Premium Plus. This is what we're going to take a look at first. You know, what that is, it's a heat applied material that's a single color. You know, that could be ordered, you know, as custom cuts through Stahls, or if you have a vinyl cutter, it can be ordered by the roll and you can cut it yourself. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and apply today to this Performance Gear 100% polyester Sport Tech, and we're going to apply our Neon Premium Plus. And the biggest advantage of Premium Plus is it goes on at a very low temperature of 280 degrees. And what that does is extremely minimize the possibility that you're going to have a heat press mark on the, on this garment when you're done. You know, most of the, like thermofoam, for instance, if you try to, it'll stick to this, no problem. But the pressure and the high heat is likely going to discolor this shirt a little bit and also leave that heat press mark. So what the Premium Plus was brought on for is so that you know confidently you could decorate this and people are going to buy it because it's going to look like it's a professional decoration. And so we have our Fusion over here set up at 280 degrees. So we'll have Joe come follow me again. We're going to change out our hat platen.
Mike, we have a question.
Okay. We have a question. Go ahead.
Can you use the hat press for decorating sleeves?
Yes, which I will show you this here in a little bit. It's actually going to be coming up very soon. That's a great question, however. That's one of the nice things about a cap press is, yes, that's what it was developed before, you know, but there's so many other ways that you could decorate things with a cap press, which I'll show you here in a little bit. So we have our 16 by 20 platen back on. So I'm going to go ahead and load our performance fabric or shirt on here. Make sure we're straight. Place our Premium Plus. Set here for 280 degrees. And Jody, the time again on the Premium Plus, 10 seconds?
8 to 12 seconds.
Okay. We'll go ahead and do 10. Draw back my pressure a little bit. It's going the wrong way. This is a warm peel product, so I don't want to peel it hot. So when you have a product that's a warm or a cool peel, that adhesive is setting as it's cooling. And there we have it. No real evidence of a heat press mark due to that low temperature application. It's very smooth, very soft, almost one with the garment with this type of material, which people, that's what they're looking for. They don't want anything thick and bulky. You know, like I definitely wouldn't recommend using a thermofilm pre-cut on this. And yes, it will stick, but it's not going to feel very comfortable for the runner or for the athlete who's wearing it. The Premium Plus is very, very thin, very soft, and it will stretch and rebound with these garments and not distort the image at all. Okay. Now let's take a look at this at a similar type of garment, but this one, it's a trouble color. It's red. Red, maroons, garments such as this have a very high tendency for bleed through. And what that is a lot of these polyesters, they're dye sublimated to get that dye. And when you heat these garments, what happens is those dyes in the threads reactivate and they'll just naturally bleed through the white surface. So this is another innovation that Stahls has come up with, and it's called our SuperTech Sublistop. And this is a digitally printed material, you know, that we offer as a service, or, you know, for those of you digital printing with a solvent or eco-solvent printer, could print on your own printer. And this, the beauty of this product is the charcoal black background. And what this does is it prevents any of the dye that would be reactivated in these threads. It'll prevent it from bleeding through with this black carrier. So that the whites, once applied, they're going to stay white. They're not going to turn pink. So the way it looks now is the way it's going to look after it's been dried, worn, you know, any number of times. It's going to stay true to that color without any dye migration. So just, you know, most standard materials and, you know, even the standard screen printing inks, these types of garments are very difficult to decorate due to that dye migration. You know, one of the bad things is sometimes you don't even know if it's going to bleed until after it's been pressed. You know, you may have already shipped them out to the customer. It looked A-OK once you sent it out. But as soon as it gets to the customer, they call you back and they say, hey, my white lettering or my whites from my logo, they turn pink. And that is why. So anytime decorating performance gear, you know, that's red or maroon or any color, I highly recommend using our SuperTech Sublistop. So that way it gives you a peace of mind that you know that it's not going to bleed through. And again, the beauty of this one as well, it goes on at a very low temperature of 280 degrees. So I'm going to cover that with a craft paper. And this is a two-hit application, initial hit of 280 degrees for 5 seconds. That initial hit of 5 seconds, we'll open it up. And then we'll remove this mask. Again, this isn't exactly a hot peel, more of a warm. And then we're going to cover this again for an additional 5 seconds to complete the application. Have a completed decoration there with one of our CAD prints designs, the SuperTech Sublistop. You can see just like the Premium Plus, that low temperature, no heat press mark, and also there's no dye migration coming through on that white, so that white is going to stay white for the life of this garment. Right. And that, you know, that covers our, you know, torso applications there. Jody, are there any questions right now?
Actually, we do have a question.
Okay.
At what point should you use the flexible cover sheet that is made out of the rubbery material?
I like to use the flexible application pad when I'm decorating shoes. And even sometimes, some garments, even though they, you know, let's say we're applying the Premium Plus or the SuperTech where they're going on at 280, sometimes there's still evidence of heat press marks. And if I see that, again, that's when I'll go to my flexible application pad, and that will drastically reduce, you know, the possibility of the heat press marks as well. Any others?
Questions?
All right. So now let's go on to, you know, another popular application. That's, you know, since somebody asked about a cap press, can you do sleeves with them? Yes, you could do sleeves, which I'll show you, but we have a shorts application that I'm going to do here quickly. But I have to drop this to temperature. We could easily decorate sleeves and shorts, and I'll show some examples while this is cooling down. Okay. So where's my jersey at? So we had, you know, an audience member ask a question about using a cap press to decorate sleeves. Yes, we absolutely could. Like, I would have preferred to use the cap press in our football jersey to do the decoration of the sleeves here, because it is so much easier without any additional accessories. Now, granted, I couldn't use this platen, obviously, because my transfer is bigger than the platen itself. So this leads back to, you know, what cap platen do you use? I would have used a bigger platen, which unfortunately I don't have in here with me right now, that would have accommodated this size here. So I wouldn't have had to worry about using another pad here. Just place my shoulder print over just like so. And there I would have been able to heat press that the same way I did on that with the sleeve platen, as well as the Print Perfect pad. So in this case, I wouldn't have had to have used it. So even if I wanted to do it, you know, do it here, you know, I don't know how much this is going to stretch, but I could have done it here too, you know, on the outside of the sleeve, easily on the cap press. Or, you know, let's say you have your own clothing label, another popular way to brand yourself. You know, to put your own company logo and information here, you know, in the back of the plate in place of the tag. You could have your company logo placed right there. Quick zap with the heat press, you have your own branded apparel. Another application, again, the same thing, kind of. You know, you're doing the nape of the neck. Small little circular logo or the football team's logo right there. Quick heat press, and you have another placement. You know, a lot of times, you know, in a heat printing business, you'll charge anywhere from $3 to $5 per heat press application. So, you know, those couple of extra applications may have just added $10 to this jersey for you in no time. So, as our cap press is counting down, we'll go ahead and get our shorts here. That's Joe, I'll lay these down here. These are just some basic, you know, running shorts, or possibly, I've seen some practice soccer jerseys, you know, they use this type of short as well. So rather than load these shorts onto a larger flat press and, you know, trying to figure out which platen I'm going to use, I'm going to use my cap press to decorate these as well. Very similar to that of the sleeve and how I'm going to place it there. I'll just pull this down over here like this, try to find area. And what I'm going to print here, it's another CAD print design. This is using our Foil Tech metallic silver. As you can see, this is a metallic gold. Thanks, Jody. This is our metallic gold Foil Tech. And as you can see, this is digitally printed. You get a nice metallic finish. So those of you, again, with a solvent or eco-solvent printer, you have the ability to order this in roll form and print transfers yourself. Or for those of you that don't and just have a heat press or only cutting capabilities, you can order our CAD print service to, you know, to offer these types of specialty finishes, which ultimately, again, add to more profit because there's an upcharge for, you know, for transfers like this. So go ahead and cover this. And this is the tech line, again, which will apply at, you know, 280 to 300 degrees for 5 seconds on the initial application. Let that cool a little bit. Move our backing. An additional 5 seconds. And there we have our completed shorts. Take that off. Nice gold metallic finish. So we could have also done the other leg if we wanted to. And possibly another decoration method. Now here I'd maybe want to use some sort of pad if I wanted to put a logo in here. And just to raise that up to avoid these here. So a lot of opportunities with the cap press. Even if you wanted to do a backside print, you could do the same thing there. You could load this on, and you could do a print there on the backside. So many opportunities. Yes, caps. The cap press was, you know, ultimately developed to decorate caps, you know. But there's so many other opportunities there for you to utilize it, you know, outside of just caps. All right. So let's see. We've covered hats. We've covered jerseys, t-shirts, some shorts. So what else do sports athletes wear these days? Warm-ups, you know, basketball players, soccer players. You know, they're out warming up. They wear warm-up suits or, you know, track suits, things like that. And this is another hard to decorate fabric because a lot of times, you know, they're made out of a nylon or polyester, which also has the possibility for dye migration. So, again, our Super Tech or our Premium Plus is a great way to decorate these types of items because it's thin, you know, and can apply to, you know, various surfaces. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this warm-up jacket here, and we're also going to take the pants here, and we're going to decorate an entire warm-up outfit here with just, again, just a heat press. And the jacket we have here, Joe, I'm going to have you come in again, and we're going to use this press, Fusion. And what we're going to do is we're going to do a left chest logo here, which some people might want to stay away from, again, because maybe they're afraid, you know, the zipper's going to melt. They don't have the proper attachments to avoid it. So we'll go ahead and show you how to do that with just a simple change of a platen. And this is going to be our Super Tech again, you know, because of the adhesive and the performance wear nature of this product. I'm going to bring back my sleeve and leg platen. This loaded. So this way, my jacket, that zipper, not going to be under the heat press at all. There's not going to be any worries there. I'm going to place a little left chest logo on here using a CAD print. And now, Jody, this is the Foil Tech Metallic Silver, am I correct? Okay. As you can see, the products I'm using throughout this demonstration are very versatile and have a wide variety of applications. All those finishes. So there's really nothing you can't offer your customer anymore. So we'll go ahead and place that there. Cover sheet on. .280, 5 seconds. A little bit, and remove. Cover once again. Now I'm using a craft paper in all my applications here today, and I'm using craft paper, you know, over my digital transfers because they give it a little more of a matte finish. Sometimes when using a Teflon sheet or a reusable cover sheet, it'll leave a glossy finish over the transfer that sometimes people don't like, so I prefer the craft paper just because of the matte finish of it. 5 additional seconds. And we have our left chest logo on a nylon jacket. And you saw I used the sleeve and leg platen here, which traditionally what do we use that for? Is just to, you know, to quickly and easily decorate sleeves. So with that being said, let's go ahead and decorate the sleeve of this jacket. See how easy it is to just go from one application to another without having to really do much changes on your heat press. Jody, did we read up or down? This way? Down. Now this is the Premium Plus. Go on at 280 degrees. Let that cool before we peel. longer. We'll take it off the press. Here's another application that was done, which is pretty unique. We've decorated on the hood. What we did was we loaded a 6x10 platen on the heat press and just laid that over. We had that same similar application on the hood. Another unique application that you could do with some optional platens in your heat press. So we should be cooled by now. There we have. Now sticking with that garment here, go ahead and decorate the bottoms using that same sleeve and leg platen. Left or right leg, Jody? Do the right. All right. So easy those load on there. All the piping, the seams from the inside, fall to the side. Nice, flat. I read down. Anyway. Again, this is the Premium Plus. Do this for 10 seconds. Okay. Any questions, Jody?
No questions.
Take these off, allow this to cool a little bit. You know, so there's another full application and more opportunity to generate some sales for you. You know, thinking outside of the box instead of just doing, you know, your standard names, numbers on the back of jerseys, t-shirts, things like that. So far we've decorated a hat, we've decorated performance wear, which is a hard to do thing here. You saw the perfect materials that you're going to need for that. You need, you know, either our CAD print service with the tech, the proper heat press attachments, or yeah, also besides the tech, the Premium Plus, and we did the tracksuit or the warm-up gear. You know, you could easily decorate that, you know, with just a couple of changes of the heat press platen. You saw, you know, decorating the sleeve, the left chest, and the leg. I didn't even have to change the platen, just use one platen for every application. And so now that this is done, we have, you know, our decorated pant legs now. Any questions, Jody? All right, so we've done shorts, we've done pants, we've done jackets, the jerseys. Now, let's take it another innovation that Stahls has created. You know, it's for their heat press, the shoe platen. You know, a lot of times people don't even think about being able to decorate shoes. Do we have a pair of scissors so I can cut these? So it's a relatively new application that we've been highlighting here with the manufacturer of the heat press platen, the shoe platen by Hotronics. So as she's grabbing the scissors, we have our heat shoe platen here. You know, which we can quickly and easily decorate shoes. Jody so kindly got me my scissors, and I thank you. All right, so what we could do.
Mike, I have a question for you.
Okay, go ahead.
What is the technique of the item on the back wall, the purple one and the middle one?
The purple one and the middle one. The purple jersey that you see here, Joe, I'll go ahead and let you zoom in here. This is a jersey decorated with our glitter flake, which after the shoes I was going to get into you know, a little bit of, you know, also customizing fan gear, not only for, you know, you're decorating for the team, you know, but parents are suckers. I got a kid who plays soccer, who plays baseball. It has his name on it. I'm going to buy it. Parents are easy sells. So this one is decorated with a glitter flake, which I'll show you here after we decorate the shoes. And now the one stepping over to Joe's right, This is our Super Tech Clear. And what this is, this material, it's a digitally printable material, or CAD print, that's normally designed to go on white colors and very light colors. So those with a solvent printer or Ego solvent printer, you'll basically print this full color, you know, for a full color application on a white. So what we did is, instead of actually printing on it, putting the clear on a specific color gives it a tone-on-tone look, which is very unique and I think very, very cool. It's a very thin, very soft hand, and just like all the other tech products and even the Premium Plus, it's more one with the garment, so it's very thin, very soft, very stretchable. Anything else?
No other questions.
All right. So let's go ahead back to the shoes, and Joe, we're going to use our Fusion there to the left. So we'll take off our sleeve. Place our shoe platen on there. Lock it down. And now let's decorate our shoes. Show you how this works. So we can take our cleats. Some of these laces out of here. Okay. Sit on there like that. Do the other shoe. This was another hot item, you know, when we introduced this, you know, once we took it to trade shows, you know, people talked about decorating shoes and we said it was possible, you know, but until we had, you know, this set up at a trade show and folks actually walking by and, you know, us showing them how to do it, they were blown away that you could actually decorate shoes. You know, I've seen, you know, in the combines and pro days and whatnot for college athletes, a lot of them personalizing their shoes just like they do their shirts and everything else. So, again, for you, this is just another revenue-generating opportunity for you, you know, with your heat press. So we have a number 23 for that part. And we have a number 23 for this side. So here is where I'll use my flexible application pad. Thank you, Joe. Place that over there. And this is really used to protect the shoe itself, not so much anything with the transfer. Temperature a little bit here, about 200-300. 320 for 15 seconds. Okay, so well, that's perfect timing. So while this heats up a little bit, let's take this question.
Is there something that we should be watching out for when figuring out a particular pair of shoes are able to be decorated?
I mean, the best way to do that, again, is kind of the way you pick your platen. As long as they fit on there properly and you get a nice, there's no, you know, bumps or curves on there that's going to affect that adhesion. You know, if it sits on there nice and flat, you're going to be able to decorate that. You know, sometimes, unfortunately, you don't know until you buy the shoes. I mean, if at all possible, take that platen with you in a bag. If you're picking out the shoes, make sure it fits on there, and then you know it's going to work for you all the time. What else?
No other questions.
So we're at 283 degrees right now. So while that's heating, I'll show you. We have a finished pair of cleats here. And we'll still do the application, but you know, so you can see what it's going to look like. I would definitely not fit in these shoes, but you'll see here, number 46 right there. That's almost a part of the leather. I mean, there's almost no hand to that whatsoever. And that's stuck on there for good. And I guess we didn't decorate this side. I thought we did. But you get the idea. We'll see on this one since we're going to decorate two. What other questions, Jody? Anything? We have another 10 degrees to go. So, I mean, this would be a nice time for, you know, any questions, anything you want to possibly see done with any other transfers I have remaining.
They want to know what material are on the shoes, which is fashion film electric.
That's our fashion film electric. Again, that's a It's a product that you can order, you know, with our cutting services through Stahls ID, or if you have a vinyl cutter, you could purchase the fashion film by the roll, you know, to cut those yourselves in any number of fonts, any color. So, you know, and doing things yourself, you know, with a vinyl cutter or with a digital printer, that the advantages of them doing yourself is because you basically have all the control of what you want to do as far as the design goes. You know, with Stahls, let's say you're wearing the pre-cut numbers or pre-cut names, you know, you're limited to a certain set of fonts. You know, so, you know, when you're doing themselves, you can do it any color, any font that you so choose, anything that you're able to cut, you know, you can make it, you know, with that particular font. Also, in doing them yourself, you know, you're cutting out any lead time. You know, maybe you order through us, you order through Transfer Express. You know, we try to get it to you as soon as we can, anywhere from the 1 to 5 day window, depending on when you order and what you order. You know, you're doing them yourself, you're doing more on demand. You know, you don't have to worry about as much inventory control because you're producing on demand, so you're only producing what you need. You know, so you may order a certain number of the cuts from Stahls, and you may not use 10 of them or something like that. Do you over-ordered or, you know, a couple of kids quit or whatever it may be. You know, so you're stuck with that, and, you know, maybe you'll be able to use them down the road, just numbers, you know, you'll always be able to use them. But, you know, some advantage of doing it yourself is, you know, you have that inventory control and the control of the customization that you want to be able to offer. Right. So we're at 307. I think we'll be able to go ahead and get this one done here. So let's give it a lock it down. I'm going to use a little bit more pressure on there. Fashion film, hotel product. Let's peel that away. 23 there. And we have 23 there. So we have decorated shoes here. Certain types of shoes that'll fit on here. I've seen. You know, and we've done some videos in the past where if these were sandals, you could load them on this way, and you could decorate the strap that comes over the feet there. I've seen some shoes able to be placed on there like this because they sit a lot flatter than these do, and you could actually decorate the back of the shoe here. But this shoe isn't very conducive for that type of that area for application. But depending on the shoes, there's a number of different opportunities for placements here with the shoe platen and the particular shoe that you use. And this shoe platen will fit on any of the Hotronics heat presses, from the Max, the Auto Clamp, to the Fusion, to the Air Fusion. So, without any limitations on, you know, which press that it could fit on. And the sleeve and leg platen, which you saw, you know, that's definitely ideal for the Fusion and Air Fusion. Not so much for the Max, just due to the style of that press. It's very difficult to thread. You know, you do have the very difficult to thread a sleeve or a leg on there properly. So we don't recommend the clamshell style, but I mean, it'll fit on there, but it's not going to have the same effect as if you've used it with a Fusion.
I have a question.
Back to the front view.
How much could you get for the numbers on the shoes?
The numbers on the shoes, again, that's a very specialized application. So, I mean, I've seen people decorating at tournaments and events, you know, where if just do a sleeve print or a back print, you know, they'll charge anywhere from $3 to $5 for placement. And I don't see any problem with you being able to get that, you know, with a shoe because it's so unique. Now, again, every market's different, every area's different. So, I mean, you know the demand. I mean, if you can give, I don't see any reason why you couldn't get a $5 upcharge just to decorate a shoe with not even probably a penny's worth of material. What else?
Questions.
No other questions? Okay. So, we covered, head, covered our torso area, we covered our legs, shorts with the pants, we've covered our feet. You know, let's take a look at another auxiliary item. You know, if you're playing sports, more often than not, you're going to have some sort of bag carrying all your gear. Why not decorate that as well? So what we're going to do here is we have a nice little gym bag here that we're going to decorate with our thermofilm. And so looking at this bag, at first glance, You know, how am I going to decorate this bag with all these zippers, these straps? You know, how the heck am I going to get this placement like this? Well, we can do that with the air fusion and an optional platen, which we're going to go show you here. So I'm going to use, this is the 6x10, correct, Joe? The 6x10. Where's my remote? I'm going to have Joe zoom into our heat press here. And this platen just goes in, just like all the other ones you saw in the video. So pop that in there, lock it in place. And we'll hear the music of our air compressor. See, just open that bag up, place it on there like that. So none of this vinyl piping or anything like that. We're not gonna have to worry about any melting there, any interference for the press. Place our transfer. Bring it on across. This is thermofilm I'm applying. 330, 6 to 8 seconds. Now we've just decorated a gym bag. Something you may never even thought of before, just due to the way that this bag looks. I mean, even, you know, we have a zipper front here. You know, even if we wanted to do the front of this here, I'm going to thread that on there. I can get it onto here, but if I want to do a press, I'm going to go back to my Print Perfect pad, place that in there, and now I could decorate the front. No zippers are going to get in my way. None of this piping is going to get in my way. Yet another placement opportunity and another add-on portion to your sale. If I wanted to do the top here, this one would be a little more challenging as far as, you know, keeping it stuck on there. But I can place that on there like that. Straps are gone. Zippers are gone. There I have another opportunity for profit there, you know, with a name or a logo for the school or whoever he's playing for. So just so many opportunities with just, you know, a heat press and the simple change of a platen, you know, allows you to decorate so many items. All right, so there's the gym bag, the apparel. Let me go ahead and switch to the front view. Okay. So, I mean, we've decorated the entire athlete from head to toe and even some auxiliary items with his bag to carry all the gear in. So one other opportunity, you're already decorating for the leagues, you're already decorating for the players, you know, so why not market to the parents as well? Like I was saying before, you know, my son plays soccer and he plays baseball. Parents are suckers to buy stuff with their kids on it, especially my wife. She would wear this shirt here. So, in this football jersey, we're going to decorate it just with our glitter flake available in pre-cuts. Go back to my full press. Have jersey here. I'll have Joe come in. Just get close-ups of the application. Now we have our CAD cut glitter flake. Again, ordered as a pre-cut service, or for those of you who have your own vinyl cutter, it can be ordered in roll form in any number of colors. You know, for heat press, this is good for cottons and polyesters, polycotton blends. Goes on at 320 for 15, Jody. So there's many opportunities for fan gear when it comes to a pair of basic t-shirts, jerseys such as this. Pennants, flags. I've seen a number of the stadium chairs that are decorated, umbrellas. You know, again, all going back to having the proper heat press platens and heat press to allow you to fit those odd-shaped items on there. So we have our front. Let's go ahead and flip around and do the back. going to thread this. Since I don't want the stick to the other side. Name and number. Do this for an additional 5 once it releases, because I only had it set for 10. Yep. Here we have our fan gear, decorated for the parent, ready to go to cheer on little Johnny Newman. Front, back. Right. Any questions, Jody?
No questions.
Okay. So that about wraps up the athlete in mind, you know, from head, jersey, shirt, performance gear, pants, jackets. No limitation to fabric, no limitation to color of the fabric, no matter if it's a red polyester where you typically get the dyes. Stahls has a solution for you to expand your decoration opportunities from just names and numbers to anything you could think of. Like everything you saw here is all possible, even with just a heat press, because everything that you saw here can be ordered as a service, you know, from Stahls ID or Transfer Express, where they're going to screen print a transfer route, or, like I said, with Stahls with pre-cuts. Or if you have your own vinyl cutter, you know, that's, you know, you could order all these single color materials that you saw here in roll form, and you can cut them yourself and apply them to whatever it is you may want. And for those of you with solvent or eco-solvent printers, such as a Roland or a Mach-E or a Muto, all the full-color graphics that you saw here today are all available, purchased by the roll, to print on your printer, and then heat apply and customize anything that your customer may want. And for those of you, you know, with cutters and printers, you could also, one other add-on, doesn't require heat press, it's just a different roll of vinyl. It's a sign and decal vinyl. You know, this is a full color application. Basically, it's a peel and stick. You know, so you could do the soccer mom graphics for the minivan, decorate helmets. And these are all peel and stick. It looks like this one was cut just a little bit too deep. Well, this is a sticker. But it's cut a little bit too deep, so I'm having trouble pulling it off of the paper carrier. But what it is, it's a peel and stick that you could decorate helmets with, the back of the glass, the soccer mom bands, any hard, flat surface you can make a decal for, whether it's a full-color decal or whether you're using a single-color lettering for vehicles or doors, helmets, just like that, with a vinyl cutter. You know, so, you know, there's many opportunities out there. You know, and with the proper equipment, there's nothing that you can't achieve decoration-wise, especially with sportswear, because there's so many things there involved for you to do. And with that, you know, we'll see if there's any questions to close out the presentation.
Questions.
All right. Well, I appreciate everybody's attendance today and attentiveness, and, you know, listen to me ramble on a little bit here, but I hope everything was informative for you. You learned a lot, and now it's time for you to go and decorate everything that you can. Thanks a lot, and we'll see you soon.